Integrate the dark within. We have an enormous amount of respect for humanity. We know that you chose very challenging paths for yourselves in this lifetime of ascension. You could not but help face these challenges at a time when the entire multiverse is ascending. Because everything must surface from inside of you and from the shadows. All of you are being given a chance to look inside of yourselves. And many of you started the process by looking outside of yourselves. And by seeing the corruption in others, institutions, and systems that you once placed your trust in, you have uncovered something that exists as a part of the human experience. Everything that you desire that is out there, outside of you, is also inside of you. We all live in a holographic universe. There is no separation. Every part contains the whole. Therefore, it serves no purpose for any human to point a finger and judge people, organizations, systems, and institutions that are doing harm on purpose. Every single individual who becomes aware of the darkness must acknowledge that the darkness exists within them also, and acknowledge that it is surfacing and triggering that individual because there is healing and forgiveness that is needed within that individual. You cannot remove the darkness because the consciousness that created those circumstances will still exist. You are there to elevate the level of consciousness there on Earth, and it all begins by doing it, elevating it within yourself. You are the point from which everything is being created and experienced. It must be you to choose to change yourself. Therefore, when you see something that you do not like outside of yourself, turn it all around onto yourself as it is reflecting an aspect of you. Ask yourself, how can you do better? And how can you become more of who you really are as a being of unconditional love? By knowing that you have also had moments or experiences where you have lowered your love, where you have not been your best self in all situations, allows you to understand others and makes it easier for you to forgive others, especially those who never received any love from anyone else in their lives. Imagine what that must be like. When you find you have nothing to do or do not know what to do, turn your consciousness inwards and find the love that you truly are in your heart space. Breathe into it, magnify it, and fill your whole body with love. Then fill your energy field with it, and go out into the world as love. Start your day by periodically reminding yourself that you are there to be love, and that the love that you are to always exist inside of you. Know that you always have the power to activate it within you, and you do not have to wait until something lovable or someone lovable comes along. We get very excited every time we see someone choosing love, and we see more and more people doing it all the time. It is what we all are, and what is needed more than anything else on the planet right now. We choose to focus only on the more positive futures for humanity, and we suggest that you all do the same. By you focusing on the most positive future timelines for humanity, you grow and expand to include more positive experiences, as we do. We realize that we are co-creating these positive futures with all of you who are focused on the best possible timelines for humanity. Those of you who have trained yourselves to think positively and to expect the best are co-creating with all of us in the higher realms. And what we see is the most beautiful, magical, wondrous ascension experiences for individuals and for humanity as a collective. You are choosing which version of the future you are aligning with right now, and you are doing so with the vibration that you are offering. As you know, there is not one future, and every future is malleable. capable of being influenced or altered by internal or external forces. Every future can contain more magical experiences of joy and delight. Every future expands with your focus upon them to contain more of those fantastically heart-opening experiences that you all want to have. Many of you have chosen to ignore mainstream media. Now you must do the same with New Agers who are preaching doom and gloom about the future, and you do so using your discernment. You must determine whether you want to add more energy to a negative timeline, and the only way to do that is to tune in to how you are feeling when you see someone predicting negative news of what is to come, and everything else people are convinced must happen in order for humanity to grow. You can grow by focusing on your heart, the love that you are, the source energy being that you are and that everyone else is. We invite you to join us in that positive expectation that we have for all of you who know how to use the power of your focus to create realities and to put more energy towards what you want to experience. Our primary goal is to connect with all of you as non-physical beings. We do not have physical bodies, nor do we have ships that we can land there on Earth. However, there are physical Arcturians, and there are ships that are Arcturian, and you can connect with other beings who originally came from our star system. There are people who assume that we are all the Arcturians, but we are not. We are just one grouping of non-physical consciousness that have a unique perspective that we want to share with all of you. Now, there are other physical ETs with ships who are connected to humanity in very real ways. And they are the most appropriate ones to be making first contact with all of you. There are, of course, Pleiadians along with other beings who are assisting you from behind the scenes that have physical bodies. However, the non-physical support that you all have is enormous and outweighs anything we could do for you in the physical realm. Many of you think that the purpose of extraterrestrials is to rescue you and take all the good ones away to another world, possibly another Earth, or that the purpose of ETs is to come and remove all the inequities and inequalities, all the systems, governments, corporations, and heads of these entities, so that humanity can thrive without the interference of lust for greed and power. We understand that some of you feel that these things are unfair, and that our guidance from a non-physical form is too airy-fairy, and some of you get frustrated with it. However, it is only because you do not know how powerful you are. If you knew you are creating it all, and doing so for your own expansion and evolution, then you would recognize that you are the ones to release humanity from the shackles and servitude. The physical ETs are waiting for you all to recognize how powerful you are, and do not want to be seen as gods or saviors. They want you to see them as equals, and that you have as much to share with them as they have with you. You must seek inner peace, balance, compassion, and unconditional love within yourself, and do so joyously in order to raise your level of consciousness to the point where you are ready to stand face to face with one of these higher vibrational beings that you will see as your friends and colleagues when they do land. Your goal, your mission, and purpose is just that. It is what this life is all about. It was never about the light defeating the dark. It has always been about the light choosing to be the light despite the presence of the dark, and therefore integrating the dark within. It also assists the dark out there to see the light within them. You can do that right now, and you do not have to wait until everyone else is doing it. You certainly do not have to wait for critical mass of 144,000 individuals doing it all at once. You can do it right now and change everything, and that is what we are sharing with you. This new year has brought with it new hope for so many as you continue to move towards your new entry point to the galactic community. There are more awakened souls on planet Earth today than there has ever been at any other point in human history, because of the work that people are doing on themselves, regardless of whether they are religious or not, Everyone's contribution is assisting to the entirety of the human collective. There are many paths to God, Source, all that is, or whatever you call it, because all paths lead there. No matter what method or understanding people are using in raising their consciousness into a higher vibrational state, they are all valuable to the human collective. It is not so much what you do or believe that matters, as long as you are striving to become a more whole being, a person operating from love and compassion, rather than from fear and judgment. Although we often talk about the number of awakened souls and of being a part of the awakened collective, know that everyone there on earth who is doing their part, tipping the scales, is making a difference in the overall vibration of the human collective consciousness. When you feel compassion for those who have been in an earthquake or any other natural disasters, what you believe in does not matter because you are all assisting in bringing humanity to that next level of consciousness, and know that anyone can do that. We see you growing by leaps and bounds because more people are choosing compassion, and we are needing to keep up the energies that we send you, and the energies must be of the right frequency for them to assist you. Even though there may still be people who are focusing on what is wrong with humanity and life there on Earth, thinking that things are getting worse and not better, remember that you as a collective do tend to highlight the problems in an attempt to fix them, rather than highlighting what is going well and congratulating yourselves, your accomplishments, and progress thus far. This is why we will continue to nudge you towards the most positive and powerful timelines, and we can feel the shifts within each individual that is working on themselves. You are catapulting yourselves into a higher level of consciousness, and you are doing it one moment at a time, one choice at a time, and for this reason we are optimistic about the human collective and where you are going. Those who are sensitive and willing to open up and feel into the energies that we are sending you right now have assisted in all this progress. We love to share our perspective with you as we know it broadens your minds, and when you encounter higher vibrational energy, it also expands your hearts. We only come to offer you an invitation to exist in higher states of consciousness and not to give you answers to single burning questions. There are others offering their perspective to you, and when you encounter that perspective, remember to ask yourselves whether it resonates, whether it feels right, and whether it takes you into a higher state of consciousness before you chose to accept their invitation. This is a time for discernment for all of you, and not about whether something is logical to you at this point. You have taken your logical minds as far as they possibly can take you. Now is the time for feeling into whatever it is you are considering and determining, with whether you feel more expansive or more contracted when you focus on that timeline, that opportunity, that sharing and that perspective and so on. In order for you to have a finely tuned discernment, you set your lives in a way to give you opportunities to feel particular emotions. And those not so good feelings are also needed to be felt, for you to know when something that feels good or when something feels not so good, and the only way to have that sensitivity and discernment is to allow yourselves to feel everything. You are masters of energy, of vibration, of thought and of focus, and you came to this reality with all its challenges to prove that to yourselves. You have no need to prove it to anyone else. You are the ones who want to grow and expand in that way, to become one with Source once again. That can only be experienced after giving yourselves the illusions of separation. Ask yourself regularly, am I moving closer to Source in this moment, in this thought, or am I moving further away? And you will find the answer by feeling into your body and chakras. Everything that you require is inside of you. However, in order for you to make more informed decisions, we offer you invitations, upgrades, and activations from outside of you that will assist in raising the level of consciousness inside of you. Before condemning an experience you are having, First, ask yourselves if you chose to have this experience so that you could grow from it. You are conscious and deliberate creator beings. Therefore, you need not be hard on yourselves for being that. You were masters before you incarnated there on Earth, and you are there to reveal to yourselves your own mastery. Mastery is present in the moment when you allow yourselves to feel into everything that is in your life, that is being presented to you. It is palpable, and if you allow yourselves to, you can feel it viscerally. For those who are awake, realize that every hardship faced and every time you do not succeed, how much you create for humanity. You know how reality works, and you know that there is more than one reality. Therefore, you are the ones to lead humanity into the light, knowing that the perfect planet and society that you have co-created together is available right now. There is no need to wait for free energy, full disclosure, solar flashes, nor for you to have to wait for access to your spiritual gifts and abilities, or for ETs to land. All that is required is for you to care enough about how you feel to focus on that Earth and society that you all have co-created together. It is available to those who care enough about how to feel to focus on their vibration, rather than what is wrong with society today. Continue to care for your fellow humans and the way that you have all been treating Mother Earth regarding pollution, toxins, water, soil, and so on. And you can still be focused on where you want to go, want to be, and where you want to lead humanity. Once you start focusing on what is wrong on planet Earth today, you are distracted with those problems and the finger-pointing starts. And once you are finger-pointing, you are caught in an us versus them, and once there, you are not holding a high vibration. Therefore, you must be able to recognize and see when something is not a part of the Earth and society that you want to be a part of. And you must be able to send love, healing, and compassion to all involved. Then, focus on the Earth and the version of the human collective that you do want to harmonize with vibrationally. It is possible to do this every single time you become aware of a problem, an issue, a challenge in your life. Take a good look at your health, finances, career, and relationships and ask yourselves, who is to blame? Is it my mistake? Is it the economy's or that person's fault? Or you can choose to recognize that what you are experiencing is nudging you in the direction of what you want to be living. It is entirely up to you to make that gentle shift of focusing on the beautiful version of planet Earth and that other reality that you want to be a part of, to live in and to experience. It is up to you. You can stay where you are, look for all the villains or the culprits and fight them to the death, or you can forgive them. Recognize that they are hurting in some way and need love and compassion. You can be the one who sends healing to the person who needs it the most, and then you can focus on what you would prefer to see in your society, in your fellow humans, and even in yourself. And recognize that even if you see it in someone else, then it must also exist within you. Self-forgiveness is also necessary. We know that it is easier said than done. However, that is the blueprint. That is the map that gets you to the new Earth you have all co-created. There are many energies that have been coming your way, but not enough people are open to receive them. Many think that perhaps they are not worthy of receiving assistance from above, while others believe that some deserve help, but others do not because they are heathen and unworthy of assistance from above. This is where you come forward as the way-showers, the ones who are there to be the example by leading and healing. You step forward because you want everyone to receive what it is they have been asking for you know that everyone on Earth is a being of love and light, an aspect of Source. We suggest you hold space for all of humanity to receive what they need at this time. Make yourself available to the universe by offering yourselves to be conduits of love, light, and healing energy of all the assistance that is coming. You can be the answer, be the solution, be the ones that humanity has been waiting for. And that means rising above all the debating that goes on there on your world. Assist those who do not want your assistance or who are unaware that they need it. You are there to be love incarnate. See others as parts of a whole that you are also a part of, and that you are there to make whole, to bring together, to integrate. We encourage you as the awakened collective to open yourselves up to all that humanity has been asking for. Ground it into your physical bodies and down into Mother Earth, and allow the wonderful energy grids beneath your feet to do the rest. Now is the time, and you are the ones, because you are not just holding your love for those who deserve it. You are holding your love for everyone. And this is your time to shine brightly. Te wāna, tāua, te awa.